Hey everyone. Hi everyone, it's Finola Howard and this is Ask Finola How, and you're not crazy. This is in fact Thursday and not Wednesday when we were originally going to speak to each other, and it's kind of interesting that I'm a day late when the content for today's Ask Finola How is all about content. And as we know, consistency of your content is actually paramount. It helps you build momentum. It helps you build momentum with your audience, your visibility with your audience. It's such a cornerstone of your content that it's ridiculous that I'm a day late. And I kind of thought about this and I was, and forgive my wet hair, I'm just out of the sea. And I thought about this and I went, will I pretend that nothing happened because, you know, so many more people watch this when it's not live. And I just went, no, I really need to talk about this because I think that so many people get very preoccupied with, oh my God, I missed a week, or I'm, you know, I'm the worst person possible because I'm not as consistent as I want to be. But like, stuff happens, you know. I had my notes prepared, I had it drafted. Like, you know, I always come with a couple of sheets of paper with kind of to get, make sure that my ideas for what I want to talk to you about in the Ask Finola How are clear and they follow. And if I get lost, I can, you know, look to my notes. And something happened yesterday for me and I couldn't do it. And I'm like, okay, you know, we've got to kind of take a load off and do the best we can every time. And our customers are not going to kill us because we forgot to do our 10-minute live video that day. They'd prefer if we showed up. They prefer that, you know, we were absolutely bang on for all eternity to be robotic. I mean, that's our expectations of ourselves, really. Whereas, you know, this is why I wanted to share it with you today, that I'm sorry. And I'm here now, so let's do it now. And I'd like you to think about that, so that I did get the Ask Finola How this week, out this week. I'm here, I'm answering a question, I'm here to serve. And yesterday I couldn't serve at the time I wanted to serve at, but today I can. And I do feel really awful, by the way. So it's not like it doesn't mean nothing to me. So, you know, I feel it. But I got to move on, you know. I've got to move on and answer the question that you asked of me. So let me do that now, okay? And do comment in here because I think it's interesting to accept that we're human on stuff and accept that we're all on a journey and we're going to do the best we can with how we serve our clients and our customers, and that's just the way it is. So okay, let's break the mood and let me start with what I wanted to talk to you about yesterday. And I wanted to talk to you about content. And I mean, I just thought it was so interesting that this was the week that I was doing content. So, and I'm really, consistency is so important. But just be consistent overall, you know, be consistent overall and bringing your best self every single time. I'm a real believer in that. So let's do this. OK, so let me share with you the question that was asked. OK, so anyway, I will shake it off. Like, bear with me. So where do you start with creating content pillars for your business? OK, I'm struggling to come up with mine and to make sure that they are in alignment with my overall message. Okay, content pillars. Everyone talks about content pillars, but it's such a great phrase, you know. It's such a great phrase, and this is what I want you to think about in terms of content pillars. And it's content pillars. When you think of pillars, you automatically think of four pillars in the corner of a building, you know, four corners of a building holding everything up. And that's what a pillar is. This is the content. These are pillars that hold your whole message up. So think about that, okay? And what I wanted to say to you was, last week we talked about positioning, okay? And one of the ways that your customers will recognize your positioning in the marketplace is through your content. So it's You choose. So we did this last week and we looked at all of the steps to help you find your positioning in the marketplace. And then what the next step beyond that, and I mean, that's a significant piece of work. But the next step beyond that is once you choose that positioning that you want to become known for in the marketplace, then what you do is you create, you choose these pillars by which you be, that positioning stands on. Okay. And that is how you get visibility, how people get to know you and all of that good stuff. So last week you did the exercise of choosing your positioning in the marketplace. And then what we do is we draw a line in the sand and we'll say, this is what I want to become known for. This is what I'm going to use to make sure that people see me in the space that I want to become known for. Okay. And your starting point always for this, and always when I'm talking, it's always about two perspectives, your perspective, your purpose, and their perspective, what they need from you. So we start really, we've already done the positioning piece. So now we must reach out and really listen again. And we already did this last week of listening to the pain point of our customers. But from a content perspective, what you're really wanting to know is what's the pain point and how are they trying to solve it? So what are the terms that they use to find the answer to their problem? Okay. So is it like what hashtags, what keywords are they using on Google or on Bing, or where are they trying to find the answer? And what is it they're searching for? And a great, and that means that you really know the language that they're using and you really know the kind of the flavor or the approach that they're taking to solve their own problem. So a great resource for this to understand how your customers are searching is, you know, have a think about all the research that they did around the pain point of the customer. You developed your product from this, you developed your positioning from this. So then what you need to do is let's kind of hone it. Let's turn it into 2, 3, 4 pillars on which everything will be built on. Okay. So great resources for you when you're jotting down notes. So do, you know, take that piece of paper and say, okay, am I an acupuncturist who specializes in fertility? What is somebody searching for when they're looking at fertility? They could be looking at, how do I get pregnant? They could be looking for someone who's looking for hair loss answers, might be saying, hair loss, male hair loss, age 35. You know what I mean? What are they looking for? And note it down and kind of brainstorm all this down and see the pattern that emerges as you brainstorm. And then when you've kind of done that piece of research of looking and really watching like what hashtags, which search terms, go to a few things. One, go to Google and see what comes in the drop down list for a very simple exercise. Do things like Answer the Public, which is a great site, answerthepublic.com. And if you type a phrase in, what will spit back at you is all of the things that people are searching for and the terms and the phrases they're using. And using kind of simple things like putting how, why, who, and all that kind of stuff in front of it. But it gets you a real understanding here. The other thing that I would use as a tool here would be, and you've heard me talk about these before, great book, answerthepublic.com will give you an idea of the things that they're looking for. The other thing that I would look at, another great tool, it's a headline analyzer by CoSchedule. It allow you to, if you start to pull together some blog ideas here of headlines that people that you think you might be able to write something on, then type it into Headline Studio by CoSchedule, and it'll tell you what, it'll give you this shortcut to SEO. What are the trends? What is being searched for? Which phrases are being searched for? Are you watching if something is on the increase, on the decrease? What are better phrases to use? It'll teach you all of that. Great resource. So you're pulling the information from all the stuff that you did last week around positioning. You're pulling information around what people search for to find the answer to their solution. And you're using those tools that I just talked about to help you hone that. And you're trying to really pull at how are they trying to find an answer. And then what you want to do then is sandwich with what you want to speak about. What is the answer you bring to the table? And how can we put these two perspectives in place to come up with the pillar content that your perspective of how you answer their pain? So you're getting both perspectives in here and saying, this is my positioning. This is what I will write about. These are the only things I will write about or speak about. This is the only content that I will produce. And if it's the only content you will produce, you will make sure that in these four content pillars, they're also a bit like umbrellas. So that the content pillar has to be big enough that you can talk about from so many different perspectives and really own it, but small enough that it's recognizable as a positioning, if that makes sense to you. So it's big enough that you can write a lot about, because we want you producing content every single week, original content, your perspective, your angle on things. And that allows you to become known and respected in a space, not every space, your space. So the more that you speak about your positioning piece, the more that you speak about the space you want to own, the more recognized you will become for being the source of knowledge, insight, answers, solutions in that space. And you need to be consistent about it, okay? So, you know, we've already talked about it. So the thing that I want you to do is, if you've kind of sandwiched all that together, which is their pain, your answer to their pain, you choosing the space that you want to own, and you've done this SEO research as well, you've used the tools I've just talked about, and then what you do is really test it. Test that you can write at a glance, well, not at a glance, but take a piece of paper for each of the four pillars you picked or three pillars you picked and write down and say, what four blogs could I write about that? And then what four blogs can I write about this piece over here? And what four blogs can I write about each one of these? Test them on Headline Studio. And the reason you're doing this is to make sure you have enough to write about, to make sure that that umbrella is big enough, but focused enough, big enough that you can write about from lots of different perspectives, but focused enough that it feeds your positioning. That's important. If you can't write anything about it, it's too niche. That's your test. Or you haven't thought about it enough. If you think it's too niche, go to answerthepublic.com for ideas of how you can really expand it. Or think from a bigger, and maybe it's a second customer you bring into the mix. So really work it that the content pillar is big enough for you to be consistently writing, producing content on, but small enough to be a space, okay? The next layer, so that's you really talking functionally about the space that you own, about the knowledge that you want to impart into the world, the expertise that you want to share. But the next layer in here, which is about content, is you've got to show some of you in the mix, because we hear it all the time. People buy from people. People buy from people that they know, like, and trust. So if people are buying from people like they know, like, and trust, then you can't hide. You have to show yourself. Whatever you choose to show of yourself now, I might add, but show a part of you that shows your humanity. Show a part of you that shares with the world, you know, I'd really like to work with them. They'd be great to work with. I like their perspective. I like the tack they take. That's something different I haven't heard before. That's what you want. So what is it that you, of your personality, that you can bring to the mix that shows who you are? Now, one of the great ways of showing who you are is talking about the other things that you're passionate about. So it's not always about your subject area, your area of expertise. It can be something you're really passionate about. And I thought about a couple of people who are really passionate about this stuff. And I thought about Rachel Dubber, who is a beautiful artist here in Ireland. And she produces greeting cards and aprons and lovely homewares. And she's very passionate about animals. In fact, she draws a lot. A lot of her stuff is designed around animals. And what she does is she loves donkeys. She has there's a whole story around donkeys and how they came into her life and how she's passionate about them and passionate about a lot of animals and passionate about the environment. And what she does is she shares that passion and shares that story even from the very beginning with her positioning. And Rachel actually gives a portion of her profits back to save donkeys in the donkey sanctuaries. And that's the layer of her content that lets us inside her life and allows us to understand her, and actually allows this other layer of really understanding her beautiful products, because you know it comes from this beautifully inspired space that adds this layer to other than that, we would simply be seeing somebody who produces products, who produces pieces of art, puts them on some form of product and sells them. But no, we have this other extra layer that moves beyond the ability to create and beyond the ability to create art that sits on product. We see her reason for doing it. We see her passion. And in fact, it's expressed so strongly, it could even be expressed as a movement in itself. And that's what gets you traction with customers. It also gets you traction with things like PR and all the rest of it. I mean, nobody writes a PR story about something that's just technically correct. They write stories about what people are passionate about. They write stories from the human perspective. And that helps you become more visible. And that brings your content alive because they see this other part of you. So when you think about your content, you think about your expertise and your area and the space you want to own, but sandwich that with your humanity and the things that you do differently. And that's what will open up a world of visibility for you to help your business. That's worth the effort. Okay, it's both. We need both. Okay, I'll move on. Okay, my next piece for you is start when you're thinking about producing this content, right? And it's not always about written. But when you're starting about producing this content, what I want you to think about is, how do you love to communicate? Okay, do you love to communicate verbally, to use your hands like me? But anyway, do you love to communicate verbally? Do you love to do video? Do you love to do audio? Do you like to draw something? Is that a way that you like to communicate? Do you like to write something? Start in a space that you love to be, because if you start in a space that you love to be, the chances are you have a greater chance to be more consistent in what you're doing, because there is more ease in a space that you love to be in. So I found that I actually like doing this, but I also love doing audio. But what you when you start from a space where you love to be, then your ability to produce content grows, because you're already find a comfort in a way to communicate that you can build on. So just start with one thing, one space. Is it something that you love to do? Do you love, would you love to do a podcast? So that's audio. Would you love to draw something for people, or do, you know, an Instagram live that is following how you make something, following you how you cut someone's hair, how you produce a brand, your sketch pads around that, how you work a way. It might be just somebody observing what you're doing, not necessarily another way, but start in a space, in a way or a channel or a method, a delivery method that you are most comfortable in, that you could kind of love doing. And then when you do that, you'll find that it grows. But when you do that and you start to do that consistently every single week, you can convert that every single time. You can convert a video into audio. You convert a video into a blog. Ultimately, I'd really like you to convert whatever piece you're doing into a blog, because that's written. That means if you convert it into a blog, you can then put it onto a blog on a website, which is a really strong place where you need to produce content to get help your SEO and people come to your website. So if you do video or if you do audio, convert it into a blog. Get it transcribed, make it flow, release it. In every single blog that you write, there will be nuggets of wisdom in that. You could get 10, 20, 30 posts, social media posts out of that blog every single time. And I'm happy to do that in one session of taking anybody's blog and seeing how many pieces of content I can produce from it. I'm very happy to do that in one of these sessions, because you can do that. And you can, even in each single post, can be spun a little bit differently. So you have that beautiful piece you produced as a video or audio. You can get it transcribed, turn it into a blog, take that blog and get 10 pieces of content from it in a post. put it into Canva, turn it into a single post, a carousel post, a reel, a clip, all of the many things that you can do with that. So from you starting from this place that you love to be in, you can produce multiple pieces of content. And that's why we start with pillars, because you're already starting from a positive positioning place and you're following the flow with that, following the flow so that you produce content that sticks. Okay? When you do that channel piece, do try to think about doing it every single week. As I said, turn it into a series. Ask Finola How is a series. Your Truth Shared is a podcast series. You can have many ways of doing it. The main thing is to do your best to be as consistent as you can, knowing life will get in the way like it did for me this week. But it's okay. You just keep going. Doing your best to serve as consistently as you can, serving your customers as consistently as you can, and serving your business as consistently as you can. Okay? So glad you're enjoying this, guys. Then lastly, I would say find a scheduler, really critical, so that you can actually start to produce things in batches. So all of this content that you're doing gets released through a scheduler. Things that I would recommend are Buffer is a great entry point for a scheduler for you. The other fantastic scheduler would be Agorapulse, Content Cal. There's loads of them. They will make life easier. Use them. I hope that helps everyone. And I hope it helps that we talked a little about the humanity of consistency and, you know, relaxing a little into all of this. Let me know what you think. It was lovely talking to you all today again. This was Ask Finola How. And today we talked about content pillars. Take care. Have a great day.